Hey, what's up everyone? So for this week, I want us to focus on a pretty interesting topic. And that topic is, when do we actually need to use weak self in a closure? And in order to help us understand when does it make sense to use weak self in a closure, I have written three different examples. So you can see them just behind me. The first example is a closure that is passed as an argument to map. The second example is a closure that is passed as an argument to dispatch queue main async after. And finally, the third example is a closure that is stored in a property. And as you can see, in each of these examples, I've been using weak self, even though it might not actually be necessary. So before I get started with the explanation, what do you actually think? Among these three examples, which one do you think absolutely requires us to use weak self, and which one actually do not need us to write weak self? Let me know in the comment what you think, because it will be super interesting to see if everyone is in agreement on this topic. Okay, so let's get started with the first example. Do you think we really need to use weak self here? I'm going to argue that we actually don't need to use weak self. And a good way to understand why is to actually take a look at the signature of the method map. As you can see, in the signature of the method map, the closure that I pass as an argument is not annotated with the attribute at escaping. And this is super important to notice this whenever we need to choose whether or not to use weak self. Because when a closure is not annotated with at escaping, it means that the compiler is going to check that the closure will not be used after the method has returned. Meaning that if I come back to my call site, it means that after map has returned, the closure that I have passed as an argument will no longer be in memory. And so whenever you deal with non-escaping closure, you actually don't need to write weak self inside them. And the reason why you don't need to write weak self is that it's actually impossible to create a return cycle with a non-escaping closure. And even the Swift compiler knows it, because as you can see, I can totally omit to write self in front of my method format, and the compiler will not complain, because the compiler knows that there is no risk of creating a return cycle, and thus there is no need for me to explicitly capture self. So for the first example, no weak self is needed. Now let's move on to the second example. So I'm going to try and apply the same reasoning that I had with the first example. So I'm going to take a look at the signature of the method async after. And as you can see, this time the closure that is passed as an argument to this method is indeed annotated with at escaping. However, we need to be careful here, because while at escaping does mean that the closure can stay in memory after the method has returned, it doesn't say anything about how long it will stay in memory. And if we go back to my code, we can see that since I am scheduling the execution of the closure for 2 seconds after now, the closure will actually only be kept in memory for these 2 seconds. So this means that I could actually remove weak self from my closure. I could capture a strong instance of self in the closure, and it actually wouldn't create a retain cycle, since once the closure has been executed, it's going to be removed from memory. But as you might probably imagine, it's actually more subtle than this, because this code without a weak self is going to behave differently than the code with a weak self. And to understand why, let's imagine the following situation. The method async after is called on my view model, and immediately after, the view controller that owns my view model is removed from the view hierarchy. What's going to happen then is that if I have used weak self inside my closure, the closure will be executed, but self will have a value of nil. On the other hand, if my closure has strongly captured self, the closure will be executed, self will still be in memory, and so the actual value of self will be used. So it's something that you really want to pay attention to whenever you are passing a closure that is escaping. Whether or not you are using weak self might produce a different behavior. And actually, both behaviors could be correct. It really depends on what you want to implement with your code. So for this second example, my conclusion is that weak self is not mandatory, but whether we choose to use it or not is going to change the behavior of our code, and so we need to be extra careful about it. And finally, let's focus on the third example. So I guess this one is the easiest to decide because it's really the poster child of when you need to use weak self. Here I am storing a closure in a handler. That handler is stored inside my view model. So of course, if I capture self strongly inside the closure, this is going to create a retain cycle. And so in that kind of closure, you definitely want to use weak self because otherwise you're going to have a retain cycle, which means a memory leak. And this is definitely not what you want to have in your code. So for this third example, weak self is definitely needed. Now let's try and recap what we have learned. As we've seen, when it comes to weak self, there are basically three different flavors of closures. First, we have non-escaping closures. And for this one, the choice is really easy. You do not need to use weak self inside these closures. And actually, even the compiler is aware of it because the compiler is not going to force you to explicitly capture self inside of them. Then we have escaping closures that are going to be stored indefinitely. And these closures are guaranteed to create a retain cycle. And so whenever we write one of them, we definitely want to use weak self inside it. And then finally, we have the third kind of closure, the one for which the rule is not as clear cut as for the two others. And this kind of closures is escaping closure that will not be stored indefinitely. So think, for instance, closure that you pass in to async after, or closure that you would pass when you are creating a data task to load data from the network. With this closure, the trick is that while you are not required to use weak self, because the closure will not be stored indefinitely, whether or not you use weak self actually produce a different behavior. So we really need to think about it. Do we want the closure to keep the instance of self around when it is executed or not? And it's really going to depend on what you're trying to implement. And that's the end of this video about when should we really use weak self. As always, if you have any kind of feedback, please let me know in the comments. For instance, if you think of any kind of situation that is not covered by my free example, please share it with me. I would be super curious to read it. Thank you for watching the video and see you next time.